There comes a tide in the affairs of men, my dear Blubber, when we must take the bull by the tail and face the situation.
That's the voice and philosophy of W.C. Fields, considered by many experts the greatest comic artist of all time. The character he portrayed was a composite of all human weaknesses. He was mean.
I'll go where I'll kill you.
He hated children.
You kids are disgusting. Staggering around here all day, reeking of popcorn and lollipop.
He was a drunkard.
Someday you'll drown in a vat of whiskey.
Drown in a vat of whiskey. Death, where is thy sting?
He told outrageous lies.
Did you ever play the game of Squidgelum?
No. The only game I've ever played is Beanbag.
Beanbag. Oh, it's very good. It becomes very exciting at times. I saw the championship played in Paris. Many people were killed.
It was lecherous.
Don't be so free with your hands.
Listen, honey. I was only trying to guess your weight. You take things too seriously.
He was dishonest.
I won my money. That changed for $100 bill.
No.
That's fine. I offer you your salary and you haven't changed. That's sabotage.
All I want's my salary.
Glutton.
He had a unique philosophy.
My uncle, a blooming ascensionist, Effingham Hoofnagel, took a chance. He was 3 miles and a half up in the air. He jumped out of the basket of the balloon and took a chance of lighting on a load of hay.
Golly. Mm. Did he make it?
No.
Oh.
He didn't. Had he been a younger man, he probably would have made it. That's the point. Don't wait too long in life.
He was vulgar and boorish.
You don't know my wife. The other night we had some folks at dinner. I said, Abigail, dear, is it okay if I take my vest off? She said, you don't mind keeping your pants on, do you?
Here is that Fieldsian combination of brutality and comedy. He plays a bartender who tells a customer how he handled a particularly obnoxious woman drunk.
I'm tending bar one time down the Lower East Side in New York. A tough woman comes in there by the name of Chicago Molly. I cautioned her, none of your picadillos in here. There was some hot lunch on the bar comprising of succotash, Philadelphia cream cheese, and asparagus with mayonnaise. She dips her mitt down into this melange. I'm yawning at the time, and she hits me right in the mouth. I jumps over the bar and knocks her down.
At this point, his fellow bartender, a puny little runt, interrupts.
Where's the fellow?
I don't know. It's up along there somewhere. You were there the night I knocked the Chicago Molly down, weren't you?
You knocked her down. I was the one that knocked her down.
Oh, yeah, yes, that's right. He knocked her down, but I was the one who started kicking her. I starts kicking her in the midriff. Did you ever kick a woman in the midriff that had a pair of corsets on? Well, I almost broke my great toe. I never had such a painful experience.
Did she ever come back again?
Well, I'll say she came back. She came back a week later and beat the both of us up.
Yeah, but she had another woman with her.
And yet, with all his faults, he could still play a tender farewell scene with a little child.
And if we should ever separate, my little plum, I want to give you one little bit of fatherly advice.
Yes, Pop?
Never give a sucker an even break. I ain't seized my boy and I, and cut a path through this wall of human flesh.
That is the sound of W.C. Fields. And like his character, completely original. He never said anything the simple way. Instead of saying, will you join me for breakfast? He says,
How'd you like to hide the egg and ingurgitate a few saucers of mocha java?
Instead of saying, I'm going to take a bath, he says,
right now, with your permission, I shall dunk my pink and white body in yonder Roman tub. I feel a bit gritty after the affairs of the day.
Instead of saying, you have a beautiful voice, he says,
wonderful, wonderful, wonderful. You make Jenny Lynn sound like a mangy alley cat with asthma.
He had a poet's ear for the music of words, and all of his favorite phrases seemed to have a musical cadence.
My little plum. My little dove pie. My little chickadee. Yes, my little glowworm.
My little Rocky Mountain canary. My little mud turtle dove.
Yeah, I shall join you in a habitat.
Ah, what symmetrical digits. Soft as the fuzz on a baby's arm.
Don't be a luddy-duddy. Don't be a moon calf. Don't be a jabbernowl. You're not those, are you?
My little hourglass. Come, my flock, my flower. I have some very definite pear-shaped ideas that I'd like to discuss with thee.
To avoid censorship problems, he invented his own form of profanity.
Suffering sciatica.
You come back to the reservation and milk your elk.
Oh, drat. Beelzebub! I've been hoodwinked! Agrak and appendico! Mortal.
He found great fun in just pronouncing certain words, like kumquats.
What was that you wanted?
Kumquats.
How do you spell it?
C-U-M-Q-U-A-T-S.
C-U-M-Q-U-A-T-S. Quat. Two quats?
No, one quat.
And there's the memorable scene where the man comes looking for Carl Lafong.
Is this 1726 Prill Avenue?
No.
Is there a Prill Avenue in this neighborhood?
I don't know.
Do you know a man by the name of Lafong? Carl Lafong. Capital L, small A. Capital F, small O, small N, small G. Lafong. Carl Lafong.
No, I don't know Carl Lafong. Capital L, small A. Capital F, small O, small N, small G. And if I did know Carl Lafong, I wouldn't admit it.